All right, so let's start with the big story that we are tracking on Vyond this hour. Speaking at the United Nations, India's External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar made it pretty clear that countries sponsoring terror should be held accountable. He further added that terrorists have in fact been operating virtually with impunity in both India and Afghanistan. Later, S. Jaishankar also spoke to the United States Secretary of State Anthony Blinken regarding coordination on Afghanistan. Now, Vyond's correspondent Susan Tehrani was at the UNSC press briefing in New York, and she posed a question to India's foreign minister, asking him if India will recognize the Taliban, which has now taken charge of Afghanistan. And this is what the India's foreign minister had to answer.
Thank you, Mr. Minister. This is Susan from Vyond News. India, will India recognize the Taliban, and what is India's position on the Taliban?
We've had long experiences with terrorism. I specifically mentioned the groups Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed. Where we go on from now, the immediate issue is repatriation and working with partners, especially the US, as they control the airport. France also took some of our nationals. In terms of longer perspective, we have a relationship with the Afghan people and we will continue with it.
Now, Jaishankar also said that terror groups such as the Jaish-e-Mohammed and Lashkar-e-Taiba continue to have encouragement. He also pressed for a focus on threats from the so-called Islamic State. Now, Jaishankar chaired the UNSC meeting. Remember, India, of course, is the current president of the Security Council. The Indian External Affairs Minister warned that ISIS has been expanding its footprint in South Asia. Making an indirect reference to Pakistan, Jaishankar also said that some countries have been undermining counter-terror operations.
In our own immediate neighborhood, ISIL Khorasan has become more energetic and is constantly seeking to expand its footprint. This should be taken seriously. Events unfolding in Afghanistan have naturally enhanced global concerns about their implications for both regional and international security. The heightened activities of the proscribed Haqqani network justifies this growing anxiety. Whether it is in Afghanistan or against India, groups like Lashkar-e-Taiba and Jaish-e-Mohammed continue to operate with both impunity and encouragement. In spite of the progress we have made to tighten the legal, security, financing, and other frameworks to combat terrorism, terrorists are constantly finding newer ways of motivating, resourcing, and executing acts of terror. Unfortunately, there are also some countries who seek to undermine or subvert our collective resolve to fight terrorism. That cannot be allowed to pass.
Now, highlighting India's achievements in peacekeeping efforts, S. Jaishankar also laid out an 8-point plan to counter terrorism. He said the terror financing watchdog, the Financial Action Task Force, should be strengthened. And Jaishankar also called for increased funding to the United Nations Office of Counterterrorism.
It is therefore vital that this council does not take a selective, tactical, or even a complacent view of the problems we face. We must never countenance sanctuaries for terrorists or overlook the raising of their resources. And when we see state hospitality being extended to those with innocent blood on their hand, we should never lack the courage to call out this doublespeak. We heard from the briefers of the aggravating impact of the pandemic. What is true of COVID is even more true of terrorism. None of us are safe until all of us are safe.
All right, so that was India's External Affairs Minister S. Jaishankar there. And to give us more perspective in terms of what all of this, of course, means, we are joined in by Vyond Siddhan Sibal, who's joining us live on this broadcast. Good morning to you, Siddhan. Now, we just heard the Indian Foreign Minister there, you know, indicate India's position on Taliban. At this point of time, it does not appear that India is willing to, in fact, recognize Taliban. What do you make of Jaishankar's statement?
Well, when it comes to Jaishankar's statement, he is pretty cautious because this is still an evolving situation when it comes to Afghanistan, because Afghanistan, in fact, was was mentioned by all the countries, including India, at the UNSC meet on counter-terrorism, because the biggest fear is that that Afghanistan might become a safe haven for terrorists. In fact, our Indian External Affairs Minister pointed out to Lashkar-e-Taiba, Jaish-e-Mohammed's presence in Afghanistan, the Haqqani network's presence in Afghanistan. There were other members who pointed out that how there has been increased presence of foreign terror groups in Afghanistan. So even though it was a meeting on counter-terrorism, it became a meeting on the presence of terror groups in Afghanistan and what next for Afghanistan under Taliban. But by and large, if you look at one of the main crux of the Indian External Affairs Minister's speech, he talked about a strengthening of FATF, no double standard on the issue of terrorism, no glorification of terror acts or terror activities. These were his key focus areas. He has spoken on the issue of terrorism earlier as well. In January, he spoke on the issue of terrorism and gave an 8-point agenda. But this time, the difference was that there was a shadow of what happened in Afghanistan. The Afghan worries clearly dominated the entire issue, the meeting which took place. And after the UNSC meet as well at the press Vyond, of course, was present. There were questions on Taliban, on will India recognize Taliban. His basic focus was on evacuation of the Indian citizen. That is what he talked about, how India needs to bring them back, and that remains the number one priority.
Absolutely. Now, what is interesting, Siddhant, is because besides what the Indian foreign minister has said, you know, I also want to draw your attention to what the Taliban in their very first briefing said, where the Taliban claimed that they would not allow the Afghan soil to be used by any non-state entity to mount any attacks on another nation. Will India take this Taliban's statement at face value, or India, will it be much more cautious?
Well, India will be much more cautious. This is a country which is in a state of flux. Nobody knows how governance system is working. There's not a single point government or authority where you can go. And India's biggest worry is the evacuation of its nationals. In fact, the Indian External Affairs Minister has spoken to the US Secretary of State Antony Blinken yesterday. This is the second time both sides have spoken in a matter of just 1 week. And this shows the worries over the entire issue. In fact, the Indian External Affairs Minister was on a multi-nation visit, and he had to cut short that visit. He is just coming from New York. He's coming back to India. He was expected to go to Mexico and other Latin American countries. This shows how big Afghan worries are for the regional community. And also when it comes to evacuation of the Indian nationals, so far there are 1,500 Indian nationals stuck in Afghanistan. How India will bring them back is, of course, a worry, because the Kabul airport in Afghan airspace is effectively under American control. There is a real-time coordination underway between both sides, but it is the ground movement, how you do it, because as we have been talking about, the Indian aside, the Indian diplomats were evacuated from the embassy to India, but the biggest task was bringing them to the airport from the embassy, passing through 15 checkpoints. With, of course, these are Taliban-manned checkpoints, which there were assessments that which were infiltrated by elite terror groups. They could have done anything.
Absolutely, indeed. We'll have to leave it there. Thank you very much indeed, Siddhant, for joining us and getting us all those updates there. Vyond is now available in your country. Download the app now and get all the news on the move.